Hello, everybody. This is Thannus here, and today we are back in The Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild. In this episode, we're going to be doing a side quest from Terrytown, as well as finally completing the Zora Stone Monument side quest. And we're also going to be doing three different shrines and the usual 23 Koroks. And to start things off, let's go ahead and take a side quest from this guy here.
What's the deal, Yor? I normally don't have time to mingle with commoners, but I have a feeling about you. I'll make an exception this time. Your clothes. I'm guessing you're a little hard up for cash, am I right? I appreciate your honesty. So for the down payment, I'd say 100 rupees sounds fair, yes? I don't care about the details. Here, take it. Hand.
And he gives us a silver rupee as a down payment for whatever he wants us to do.
Ho ho ho! So you accept then? Excellent! Now listen to what I have to say. The torn wetland lies to the west of here. You are aware that there are guardians there? Not just one, either. Two of them! You know how dangerous they are? So, sonny boy, I'd like you to find and wallop both of them in torn wetland. Then come and see me.
And now that we have a brand new and improved Master Sword, that should be a piece of cake for us. The Torin Wetland is this area right down here, just across the way from Terrytown. We've been there before. We've seen those guardians before. So, this job should be a piece of cake for us. We are moving across surprisingly quickly, actually. Wow. All right. So I see one of the guardians over there. We're already equipped with our Master Sword. It's time to get to work. I am sure that this man will pay us very nicely for what we achieve. It's seen us, which means business has started. The other one is all the way over there. We should be fine from him for the time being. However, this is the one we have to worry about for the time being. Okay, that was a bit of a flub. And we deflected that laser. However, this is the quickest way to take him out, so there we go. Perfect timing. Look at that. Let's take out one of his legs real quick for some extra parts. There we go. And let's go ahead and take everything he dropped. Now, it's time to take out the other one. Real quick, I think a hearty radish over here. No armor ant, that's fine. So we're gonna go ahead and work on this other guardian now. And then we'll head back to Terrytown with the good news. He sees us. No worries, we'll just do the same thing we did for the last one. Our shield broke. Our best shield that we have broke. Great. Oh, we still got the timing down at least. Come on, just a bit more. Ooh, we got him on his head. All right, that one was a bit more of a challenge for us just because we had a bit of a flub there at the start, but we still came out on top, which I count as a victory. All right, time to head back to Terrytown and give him the good news. All right, we've returned to Terrytown. Now it's time to go ahead and give him the good news. Hey, Haggy.
It's you. Do you need something else from me? Okay, okay, I saw the whole thing. You did splendidly. I'll give you the rest of the reward as I promised.
A red rupee. But he gave us 100 rupee at the start, so it's fine.
Why do you look so disappointed? It can't be because the reward is lower than the down payment, can it? You commoners with your notions and assumptions. The whole idea that a down payment is a small part of the final payment is an idea entirely unique to the common folk. In any case, our business is concluded. Go over there. Well, anywhere, really. Anywhere that isn't right here.
Welp. He's a snob, and I'm never talking to him again. Anyways, with that quest done, Well, I'm not going to go straight to Zora's domain, just because there's still something we can do here in the Akala region. So, there's a ruins area that I have marked on my map right across the way here, so I'll go ahead and see you guys when I get there. Won't be too long. Alright, now that we're down here, we see this orb here. We head right over to the sign. Only a hero bearing this ancient orb shall be granted the right of trial on Riss Peninsula. That gives us a shrine quest into the vortex. And I think it's pretty obvious what we need to do. We need to bring the orb all the way into the center of that vortex. Or this peninsula, I guess. So, we're gonna do just that. I'll go ahead and speed up this footage just so you can see exactly how it goes down. And we made it, alright. Gonna go ahead and put the ball in the pedestal now. And that will unlock the actual trial for us, because getting it here was pretty pathetically easy, actually. Even the higher level enemies still ignored us, which is sad, to say the least. So, once this is done opening up, we can go ahead and go in. My boy. Retog Zumo Shrine, alright? Let's head on in. Alright, it was phrased in the shrine quest that this would be a trial, but I guess not. I guess it's literally just a blessing. Let's see what we get. Giant Ancient Core, okay, not bad. Let's go ahead and talk to this guy and get our Spirit Orb. Alright, so now that we're done there, we're actually going to go ahead and head all the way down to the shrine we found in the last episode. I'm not going to bother trying to pronounce it, we're just going to go there. Yes. The dump. Alright, let's head on inside then. Alright, and here we are, Bravery's Grasp. Very interesting looking shrine already. I can see the chest already, which is good. Let's go ahead and shoot this and see what it does. Okay, so it actually... lowers and rises these bad boys. Thankfully, I have a little thing called a Master Sword, which gives me infinite ammo and lets me get this chest pathetically easy. And I think also the... yeah. And then, we can go ahead and head down here. Fly right on over... through that laser. And open this chest, because why not? And we get a topaz, alright. Pretty easy chest collection for this shrine, if I do say so myself. Come on. So now, I'm gonna go ahead and put a bomb right there. Grab the arrows we dropped. And I'm also gonna put a bomb on this side. So now, we can go ahead and use them to our advantage until we can't. Okay. Interesting. I don't actually remember the exact solution to this puzzle, so we might be in for a toughie. But I've completed all the shrines before, and I can do it again. I don't know how I got hurt. Oh, the laser. So I am thinking that the solution definitely involves stasis. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna head all the way back up there to that platform and see if we can't achieve our goal. So, let's go ahead and fly down to one of these lowered platforms here. And then, go ahead and get that. Like I said, I don't remember the exact solution to this puzzle, so I have to be a bit vigilant with this one. Trying to think. Alright, so that's not it. We can't freeze any of the platforms of stasis. Oh, wait a second. I just remembered. You can pick this up. See, look at that. We're solving puzzles like a pro already. Man, I can't believe I forgot that. Let's go ahead and drop it here. Head back up. That will move the platforms up and down for us. I did not need a head back up, but whatever. Once the laser heads back, it'll hit the crystal. We can head up here, and then it'll do the rest of the work all for us. Very, very easy. It also means I did not need to be hit by that laser earlier when I was grabbing the chest, but I don't care. It's my copy of the game. I can do what I want. God dang it. Including the spirit orb. Alright. Gimme, gimme, gimme. Alright, that is our fourth spirit orb of this batch, which means we're gonna now head back to Zora City so we can get our next fill for our stamina wheel, which will complete the third and final one, and also do the Zora Stone Monuments quest once and for all. Alright, we're going to go ahead and find the statue of the goddess that's here in Zora's domain. I don't actually completely recall where it is, so it might take a second to find it. Where is it? I don't remember. I do not recall whatsoever. I think it's upstairs. I got stuck on a pillar just now. Come on, come on. I know it's up here. I know it. I don't know why I used that voice to express that, but whatever. Hey, Sidon, how's it going? I'm not going to talk to you right now. Time to get our last stamina wheel upgrade. Our stamina wheel is now fully upgraded. We cannot upgrade it anymore. So now we will use the remainder of the sets of four spirit orbs we find in in order to upgrade our health. Get stuck on more pillars like I just did. So now it's time to set up and find the 10 Zora Stone Monuments. I'll see you guys at each one. Alright, as we head through the hordes of the Zolfos with electric arrows equipped, we can actually find our first Zora Stone Monument right here. History of the Zora, Part 1. As Eternal Zora's Domain, or the Eternal Zora's Domain, as told by King Dorfan. The rains have blessed Lanayru since the ancient times of an abundance of pure, clean water. Seeking a bounty of such water, the Zora gathered there. Thus, as legends go, the domain was born 10,000 years ago. The land was also rich in ore, and so a unique form of stonemasonry was developed to create our new home. The domain is one giant sculpture, a feat of architecture that has drawn admirers the world over. Our great domain will ever stand as a hallmark to the esteemed artist who made it, an eternal symbol of Zora pride. Alright, that's our first one, and our second one is right over this ridge here. If we actually head right down here, I'm going to grab these luminous stone real quick, just while we're here. Because why not grab what's available to us? This is part two, literally right here. History of the Zora, part two, a reservoir of hope, as told by King Dorfan. Once every 10 years, the Nanae region experiences unusually heavy rainfall. The Zora River flooded every time. The tides damaged not only our domain, but our people, washing away poor souls and causing great suffering and disarray. The Zora king of that time, after seeking aid from the king of Hyrule, roared out to see what could be done. By joining the architectural genius of the Zora and Hyrule's technological prowess, East Reservoir Lake was swiftly built. Thanks to this fruitful partnership, Hyrule was no longer plagued by these devastating floods. In gratitude, the Zora King promised the King of Hyrule to manage the reservoir level to protect all of Hyrule from floods. Each Zora King since has kept that oath, spanning 10,000 years. That is why the reservoir signifies our bond of Hyrule. Alright, and now I will see you guys at number 3. So if we fly down from here at Rallus Pond, where we once killed a Hinox, we can actually find the third stone monument, which is looking a bit worse for wear. History of the Zora, Part 3. Miracle of the White Scale, as told by King Dorfan. Our scholars say that in the distant past, Zora's domain had a king with no special talent for the art of war. What he lacked in skill for blade, he made up for in love for his people, and especially love for his queen. One day, news reached the king of a horde of monsters gathering in the Zadabon Highlands. The king steeled himself for war to protect his people, but the queen knew how ill-suited for the task he was. Worried for his life, she wove one of her own scales into his armor, hoping that her love would protect him in battle. It seemed for a time that the tide of the battle favored the Zora and that all would make it safely home. But the cunning Lizalfos general saw an opening and seized it, driving the king's forces into a corner. Just when the general's sword was ready to crash down upon the king, a miracle took place. An errant sunbeam reflected from the scale on his armor blinded the Lizalfos, stopping the death blow from falling. This was the chance the king needed to rally his forces and turn the tide, taking down the general and securing victory. This came to be known as the Miracle of the White Scale, a scale that only female Zora possess. It was this miracle that began the tradition of Zora princesses crafting armor for the future husbands. Alright, I'll see you guys at number 4. Number 4 is right down here. Right next to Ludo's Crossing and right below Varuda. Let's go ahead and look at it. History of the Zora, Part 4. The Light-Scale Trident, as told by King Dorfan. The Queen and I were blessed with a daughter as lovely as a jewel. We named our princess Mipha. To celebrate her birth, the smithy Dento presented Mipha with a gift, a mighty spear called the Light-Scale Trident. Mipha grew into a bright girl and soon reached the age of receiving lessons from the royal family's Order of Knights. The whole of the royal guard adored her, especially Sergeant Segan, who loved her as if she were his own kin. Under Segan's instruction, Mipha honed her skills, and her radiance grew along with her skill with the Light Scale Trident.
As a champion, Mipha made her people proud. However, once the great calamity struck, she was never to return. All of Zora's domain fell into misery. The merest thought of the princess was enough to overcome anyone with tears. As a way of offering her soul repose, they tried to send the light-scale trident drifting down the Zora River. But when they did, the trident began to glow, and Mipha's voice rang loud and clear for all Zora to hear. The light-scale trident and I are one. Abandon your grief and know joy once again. Do not cry. Just remember. And so, keeping to her request, on the day of the great calamity, the day that Mipha passed from this world, the Zora venerate the light-scale trident and remember their brave princess. Such is the origin of the Champion Festival. Alright, and now I'll see you at number 5. Alright, so here's number 5. It's right to the west of Divine Beast Varuda. Go ahead and look at it. History of the Zora, Part 5. The Sage Princess Ruto, as told by King Dorfan. Long, long ago, in a past more distant than even the Great Calamity or the creation of the Divine Beast Varuta, there was a Zora princess named Ruto. We know that she was an attendant to the Zora patron deity, and that she was a fair and lively girl, beloved to all. Around that same time, an evil man with designs on ruling the world appeared, bringing disaster upon Zora's domain. It is said that Ruto then awoke as a sage, facing this foe alongside the princes of Hyrule and the hero of legend. Her achievements are remembered not only by the Zora, they are also forever etched into the history of Hyrule. The divine beast Varuta, built ages later to face off against the Calamity Ganon, was named in honor of Ruto. That Zora princess, my sweet daughter Mipha, was chosen to pilot Ruta as surely the work of fate. Alright, that's a reference to Ocarina of Time. And now, it's time for entry 6. Down here, right next to Rotala Dam, is entry number 6. Let's go ahead and read it. History of the Zora, Part 6. Divine Beast Varuta, as told by King Dorfan. When the Divine Beast Varuta was first discovered at Zora's domain, my daughter Mipha hurried to see it. Those present that day say this an unusual sparkle of excitement in Mipha's normally calm eyes as she beheld Ruta. The princess spoke of the divine beast as she would a friend, and was overjoyed when she was chosen to pilot Ruta. Though I thought nothing of it at the time, but given events that followed, I now regret allowing this to happen. I have spent many long years consumed by guilt. My dearest wish is that her soul will know peace. I pray for it every day. Number 7 is not very far. If we head right up this mountain, it should be somewhere right around here. Entry number 7 is actually right over here. It's still relatively close to the mountain we were just at, but I was a bit wrong if it's a location. The other one I was referring to was a different one. History of the Zora, Part 7. The hero who defeated the Lynel, as told by King Dorfan. There was a time when the people of land were threatened by the... I don't know what that one says. The beast Lynel, who lived on Moo Mountain. But one Hylian drove the beast back and restored peace to the domain. The Zora Helm won this fight. I'm trying to read this, but I have no idea what it says. The Zora Helm won this fight is now north of the... Time has taken its toll on this. I'm not even going to bother trying to read the rest of it. That's how messy it was. So, what I'm going to do, I'm going to head back to Zora's domain. Or actually, no. What I'm going to do is place this medallion here. And then head back to Zora's domain. And then we'll read it again once it's restored. So, evidently, that did not work. So, instead, we're just going to find the other ones. And we'll come back once we're done with everything. Alright, this is the one I was referring to earlier. Let's go ahead and check it out. History of the Zora, Addendum 1. King Dorfan stands his ground. Around 100 years after King Dorfan ascended to the throne, a stray guardian crossed upland Zorana into our domain. The guardian seemed unstoppable. Our best soldier's spears barely left a scratch on its metal hull. It was then that our King Dorfan, without a thought for his own safety, came out to face the guardian himself. With supernatural strength, he lifted the guardian and hurled it into a ravine. The impact of the fall left the guardian in pieces, and it was never to trouble another Zora ever again. The citizens celebrated the king's valor. From then on, their trust and respect for him grew beyond compare. You can still see the scar he earned that day on his forehead, a token of his triumph. All right. Time to visit the next one. Our next monument is right down this way. So if we head down here, we will actually find it pretty much immediately. What I did was teleported right above Lulu Lake to Ma Elia Shrine. Let's go ahead and look at it. History of the Zora, Addendum 2, Prince Sidon's Great Escape. There was once a giant Ectorok in Hateno Bay, large as a mountain, which terrorized the village's fishers. Hearing of the distress, Prince Sidon went forth to personally eliminate the defending Ectorok. But after this Ectorok was a tricky beast. After the prince dodged one of the stones it spat, it inhaled him whole. Such had been the fate of many strong warriors who went to slay the Ectorok. Not one had come back alive. Just as it seemed, Prince Sidon would be counted among them. The giant Ectorok twisted in pain. The tip of a silver scale spear pierced the Ectorok's stomach from within, revealing itself as the source of the beast's agony. Incredibly, Prince Sidon had fought his way out by stabbing his spear over and over into the monster's stomach. Unable to bear the pain, the Ectorok coughed up the prince and scrambled to escape. Ever since, the fishers of Hateno Bay have passed down this heroic tale, the prince who slew the fell Ectorok. And now, we have one last one. Entry 10. Our 10th and final monument is just down this way. Right over this ridge, we will find it. At least I think we will. There it is. Hello there. Let's go ahead and check it out. Memoir of a Gifted Stonemason. What an honor it was to receive a personal request from King Dorfan to craft a historical stone monument. I did not realize how much content he'd give me, though. It certainly exceeded the line limits of a single monument. I suppose I could have just shortened the text, but it felt wrong to tamper with our great king's words. Thankfully, I was able to split it all between 7 monuments to ensure that every word was preserved. I have always prided with myself with my ability to sync words! I am so very adaptable. I am humble as well. While I was at it, I thought, why not add 2 of my own? And so I created one for King Dorfan and one for Prince Sidon. True, this is outside the scope of my commission, but I believe the triumphs deserve as much. But why stop at that? Why indeed, my achievement surely deserves remembrance too. This is how his commission of 1 became 10. Of course, having increased the number of monuments, I had to find places for them all. That proved difficult. Still, it is worth it. So long as I remember to sign these monuments, my name will be remembered forever, as it should be. He did not remember to sign the monuments. Anyway, head back to Zora's domain, which just so happens to be right across the way here. And we'll go ahead and speak to the elderly Zora man who wanted us to read all of them. Link, it would seem you have checked all the stone monuments for me. Now then, please tell me what was written on them. The history, culture, folklore, and various heroic acts of the proud Zora people. It's all here. Eureka! Thanks to you, I've compiled the precious information from those stone monuments. Link, thank you for taking on such an arduous task. Please, allow me to reward you. Got a diamond from him. Excellent. And now, let's head back to Monument 7 and read what it said.
Looks like it's still deteriorated, so I'm just gonna have to come back at a later time. Anyways, time to head to our last shrine trial. So let's go ahead and teleport to Goron City, where we'll find our shrine quest. So if we head in here, we'll actually find our next shrine quest from none other than this guy.
My reckless brother hasn't come back yet. What in the world is he thinking? My little brother Gongoron. I'm really proud of him, but he said he was gonna go dig up the secret of the hero, then he just took off. I really don't know what in the world got into him. I'm certain my little brother went off to Gorko Tunnels, southwest of Gorko Lake. The bedrock in that tunnel is incredibly hard, so our Scorons just gave up trying to dig it out for ages ago. Instead of chasing dreams, I'd prefer to see him face reality and help us out with our important Goron work.
And that is our shrine quest, a brother's roast. So now, it's time to head, if I stop getting stuck on the environment, please, game? Okay, thank you. Let's head exactly where he told us to go. Gorko Lake is where it is the precise area. Well, no, Gorko Tunnel, but you get the idea. And now we're here at Gorko Tunnel. Let's go ahead and talk to this guy.
Phew, I'm spent. To think that somewhere behind all this rubble is the secret of the hero. I know I'll become really great and important if I can find it. My only problem is that I don't have the strength to go on. My belly's empty and rumbling like mad. What to do? Brother, so this is where you've been. I tried to think like my brother and do what he would do so I could find him. I need you to do me a favor. As a brother, I can't just sit idly by. I have to help him. Exit there and head down the hill to Gortrem Cliff. There you can find rock roast rolling around. I need you to please grab one of them for me. I'd like more than anything to go there and get it myself. It's just, well, I have a chronic condition. Yeah, it's called Goron Solder. Very serious. I'd rather not talk about it. Needless to say, I expect a lot from you. Please don't let me down.
Alright, let's go ahead and help these brothers out with their rock roast. Also, we can get through the wall and access that shrine. I wonder if the marker will go away. Okay, it looks like it doesn't want to. Okay. Oh, never mind, it just did. So now, like he said, we just head down the hill and grab a rock roast. No big deal, it should be easy. Probably. I hope. So, the rock roasts are all gonna be right down here. And as you can tell, getting up is probably gonna be a bit of an issue for us. However, we are none other than the hero himself. We should be completely fine in getting it up there. In fact, I'll just speed it up like the last shrine we did. All this has taught me is literally how horrible of a shot literally every enemy in this game is. That is one gigantic boulder, and we're fine. They threw everything they had, and they still couldn't win. Look at how powerful I am. They fear me. I just know it. And now, we deliver a hearty rock roast to the brothers, so we can get into the shrine. Foolish enemies.
Finally, I've been waiting on you. Go on, drop the roast in the pot, quickly. It's amazing. This is the finest rock roast I've ever laid eyes on. I'm gonna cook it up right now. I did it. I made a deliciously grilled rock roast. Am I hunger hallucinating, or do I smell deliciously grilled rock roast? Brother, it's ready, and you're gonna eat it and love it, and everything will be as it should be again. Ooh. Look at this! It looks so tasty, I need to eat it right away!
That texture, that crunch, ooh. That gritty feeling as it glides down my throat. Oh yes, I can't forget that savory flavor of condensed minerals seared in high heat to perfection. It's a taste explosion. It's restoring my strength. I'm like a phoenix reborn and ready to fly. In fact, I am Death Mountain. Your cooking is the best of the best, brother. Now I'm full and my Betty is happy. Let's do this. Wow, there it is. The hero's secret has revealed itself to me. Weird. I feel like I've seen something like this before in Goron City. So this is the secret of the hero, eh? It looks oddly familiar. Anyway, what an amazing discovery. That's my brother for you. And now, we can go in and get what is in the shrine for ourselves. Because we did all the work. Honestly, we deserve it. And of course, it's not just a blessing. It's called Greedy Hill. I literally just said, I did all the work. I deserve the reward. Perfect timing. It's called Greedy Hill. Awesome. Thanks for being so on the nose. Yep. This is what I'm in for. Got some rupees here that we did not collect. We did collect and we just died doing so. Alright. Got it. Oh, and we spawned on the hill itself still. Uh-oh. I'm not sure which row the chest is in. If it's even in a quote-unquote row. Uh-oh. No. Get up, Link. Link, up. Thank you. Well, I think I found the first chest, actually. Wait for this bad boy to pass by and run right in here. What do we get? We get ourselves a ruby, alright. And now we run even further up. And we get a lot of red rupees on the way up, apparently. Did not expect that, actually. No. That was a mistake. Get up, Link. Thank you. Alright, I think we're good at this point. Nothing else to fear. In fact, once we get up, we can actually fly down to that chest and run back up all over again. Anyway, we did just solve the puzzle. Puzzle, I want to say, but it was literally just running up a hill. Go ahead and grab our reward. A bomb arrow, or five bomb arrows, I guess. Decent reward, I guess. Alright, let's get our spirit orb and head on out. Alright, and now it is time to go ahead and start looking for some Koroks. I will see you guys at the first batch right down here. Alright, our first Korok is actually literally just up this way. So if we run up this hill, or climb up this hill, I guess. We will eventually reach the Korok, and with just barely all of our stamina. It looks like there's another Korok literally right next to it, which is very, very useful for us. I'm just gonna ignore that entire outpost for now. Not gonna deal with that. It's not my issue, not my problem. What is my problem is finding the rock that we need to solve this Korok puzzle. We got a shield? No, that's a mushroom. It looked like a shield from that angle. So, I'm guessing this rock is probably up this hill. It would not surprise me, so we're gonna run up there and see if we find it. Seems like it's just the right place for it to be. We run sideways. Nope, that doesn't really do anything for us, I guess. Whatever. We're no stranger to steep cliffs.
We'll climb up it just the same, all in the name of winning this Korok over. Alright. So now that we're up here, I see absolutely no rock, and I think I was just putting useless information together. No big deal. We'll find the actual rock now. If I can find it. Sometimes I guess I do have issues with this kind of stuff. Locating things that should not be very difficult to find. Come on, where are you? Know you're here somewhere. Just let me find you. I don't know why I'm talking like this, all I should. My name's Mater, Mater Toe. But you can call me Toe Mater. I'm Larry the Cable Guy. Alrighty then. Literally not finding this rock anywhere, so I think I'm just gonna cut to when I do find it. Found the rock. It's underneath the camp. Which means I might not be able to ignore it like I wanted to. The music stopped. But battle music hasn't started playing, so I don't think they actually noticed us. So I think we're good. Let's just go over here and place the rock already. And there we are. It's Korok number 1 of 23. I'll see you guys at the next one. Which, now that I think about it, is literally only a few feet away. So there's literally no reason to tell you guys I will see you at it, because there's not even going to be a cut. Let's just be honest. No cut. There's no reason to tell you guys I'll see you, because we already see each other. That's how it works, I guess. Is this shallow? This is not shallow. Okay. No matter, I can run right over. And then just push it off, push across the gap like so. See? Problem solving with your good old friend Thannus. Just like it should be. And I'm guessing it would have to go here. No? Okay. Here. Maybe. Come on. Throw me a bone here. There we go. Korok number 2 of 23. See you guys in the next one. Alright, so our third Korok is right over this way. Right next to a guardian. Okay. Might have to deal with the guardian after we take the Korok out, but that's fine. I would never mind more Korok parts. So who cares? Let's actually head right over here. And literally just throw this rock in. It's okay, that was a bit more complicated than I thought it would be. Okay, it's a little bit shallow right here. We have some leverage, throw it in. There we go. It's Korok number 3 of 23. See you guys at the next one. I'm not gonna bother fighting the guardian. Screw that. Ah, shoot, it saw me.
No.
Ooh. Narrowly escaped that blast. I don't think I'm going to escape the next one, if there is a next one, which it doesn't look like there is going to be one. I think it forgot where I was, despite having been looking straight at me. Who cares? I escaped, and that's fine. Let's get some gems from there. All right, our next Korok is literally right here. Let's go ahead and throw this bomb at this rock, blow it up, and grab the rock right underneath, which gives us Korok number 4 of 23. See you guys in the next one. And when I say that, I once again need to pay attention to where the next one is, because it's literally not very far from it, from this one at all, which means I'm stupid, and I don't even need to make a cut in the video, because I'm stupid. All right. Oh, this is a fun one. I need to wait for the Volley's Gale to recharge.
Where are we at with that anyway? Oh, 27 seconds. All right, I can wait. Might as well remove their marker for now. How many markers were down? 5. This is the 5th one, so... Nice day, isn't it? It's been a while since I've recorded one of these, by the way. It's been a while since I've recorded anything. I did record the 7th episode of Undertale, but I still need more Switch footage of the game for that. The Xbox and PlayStation footage I no longer have access to for the latter, or former.
Rivali's Gale is
and
now
I
ready.
Never had access to PlayStation footage in the first place, so what I'm going to do, I'm probably just going to find pictures or screenshots of it. Because the Switch version that I do have access to, it is more involved than those two anyway. So, it's fine to show screenshots of the other one, but the Switch version I needed access to just because there's something specific, so I managed to get that. But, enough of that aside, this is Korok number 5 of 23. I will see you guys at the next one. Alright, here we are at this Korok. Let's go ahead and grab the metal block and compare our notes real quick. It's one of these side ones that has to have the block in it. I'm not sure exactly which one. And I wish it would go in straight, but alas, that does not seem to be our typical... Okay, there we go. That is Korok number 6 of 23. The next one is right over yonder, so we won't have too much of a difficult time locating it. Because it's literally right over here. I'm guessing it's that rock right there. Yes, hi. Hello. Hello, dead enemies that I have to ignore while I get this Korok. Yep, I see you. I see your arrows. Your piddly little arrows that just missed me, despite the fact I was standing still. Anyway, that's Korok number 7 of 23 now. I'll see you guys just down below. I'm not going to bother taking out those moblins. If I head down this way, the Koroks we're looking for are literally just down here. Although whether or not they're under the ridge... Okay, it looks like this one at least is under. Yep, there's a rock that we're looking for. That's Korok number 8 of 23. And then right across the way... is Korok number 9 of 23. Now, I will see you guys in the next one. Alright, so our next Korok seed is right here. And the rock we're looking for should be somewhere in this watery area. I'm guessing right over here. Yes, there it is. Alright, so let's go ahead and pick it up. Well, I accidentally myself into getting a new type of butterfly I apparently never got before. Anyway, head right into the water here. Just make sure we stay in this shallow parts of it, just so we don't end up losing our rock. And then we can bring it right to the circle. Come on, come on, come on. Okay, it looks like we have a short path right there. Yep, we should be able to make it across, no problem at all. Alright. You spawned right in the middle of that circle, and I don't think that was purposeful at all. Anyway, here's our Korok. I don't actually know which numbered Korok this is, so let's find out real quick. This is Korok number 10 of 23. And even though it's not marked on the map, there's actually another one right over here, which means we're actually going to have to count one more than we have on our marker list now. But I happen to know where this Korok is, so why not grab it while we're here? No reason to go hand-holding on stuff I do know. Mom. When I say mom, I am referring to, of course, you, the viewer. Even though you actually haven't dictated anything I've done in this LP. Never mind. It was a bad joke, as they say. Just like that was. So, what we want to do is wait. Oh, never mind. We already had that Korok. Okay, I guess I'm just heading over there then. I'm going to teleport, because I'm not walking all that way. All right, so our next Korok is just down this way in the shallow water. At least I think it's the shallow water. Yep. And it looks like it's another rock throwing puzzle, but I don't see any rocks to throw. I'm sure we will find them in time. Yes, there they are, literally right there. Okay. See, this is exactly what happens. I mention something, unsure of whether or not it is true, and then it occurs anyway, because I'm stupid and don't know how to look at my environment correctly. Oh, Breath of the Wild 2 is going to be a fun one, ain't it? Let's head across the way here. Literally just walk across the entire stretch of shallow water that we can see best when we look down, apparently. And then throw it in. Easy, Korok. That's Korok number 11 of 23. So I will see you guys at the next one. Alright, down here near the shrine that we have apparently never seen, we have two Koroks to collect. Our first being this iron block puzzle right here. As we ignore the Octorok assailant completely, and also swim in the complete opposite direction to where I want to be. Go ahead and grab this, and we will... Come on. Work with me here, Cube. No, no, no. Don't sink. Okay, we're good. Go ahead. God dang it. Can you please, Octorok, work with me here? Alright, that's Korok number 12 of 23. And number 13 is not too far off. But first, I'm going to go ahead and get rid of this godforsaken Octorok that is now dead. And number 13 is all the way over on this edge of the lake, I should say. Let's go ahead and get our faster swimming clothes on. We're not on hot land anymore. We don't need to be wearing this clunky armor that probably makes us heavy. That Octorok is flying. Okay, I have seen everything now. Even though I already knew they could do that, and I have seen it before. Good stuff. Great. I was going to take that bass, but I guess I was too late. Shoot. Okay, there we go. And now, I'm going to do my best to... I guess Revali's Gale this. But just to be a bit more sure, we're going to jump anyway. Alright. That is Korok number 13 of 23. I will see you guys at the next one, and I will also register this shrine on our map. Perfect timing is always, Revali. Our next Korok is right up here. So we head all the way on top of this little spire here, given time. There. Okay. Yep. Uh-huh. Yep. All right. Yep. Mm-hmm. We done? Thank you. All right, I'm not climbing that entire way again. We're just going to use Revali's Gale. Get up there quicker. Anyways, like I was saying, once we get up to the top of this whole spire here, we'll be able to find this rock puzzle now. Go ahead and grab the rock right here. And looking at it here, we can clearly see the gap is right here. Let's put the rock down, and we get our 14th Korok of the day. I'll see you guys at the next one. Alright, now here is our next Korok. Literally just down this way. If we go across here, we find our Korok in this little stump right here. And by picking up the rock. That's Korok number 16, I want to say. Let's actually just check. Once I move out of the way. And I can actually get rid of this stamp. No, 15, okay. I will see you guys at the next one. Our next Korok is somewhere around here. I want to say in this stump, or hollow stump, I should say. Or not even a stump, I guess. Somewhere around here, I know that much. The exact location of it, I do not know. But apparently, there are a lot of keys here. So, it definitely benefits us to look around and see what we can find. Unless the keys do that to us, in which case, screw this area. I want to go home. And then the keys, they speak out of their mouth and say, "Fool, you are already home. I am your father." And I also really hope the lightning does not strike this tree, I should say, because this is literally the exact tree we need for the Korok. Come on. Almost there. Alright, examine the Korok now. Alright, that's Korok number 16 of 23. I'll see you guys at the next one, which is that the same Korok we're at? We're facing that way, so that's the Korok we're looking at. This is the one we just got. All right, see you at this one over this way, which appears to be in this fallen stump of sorts. I think it's just this rock right here. If it is, I'm gonna be mad. It literally is. Okay, that's Korok number 17 of 23. See you guys in the next one. Our next Korok is right here on top of this stump. So if we head up here, some balloons will appear, and apparently they don't move at all. Except for this one. Balloon? Hello? Where might ye be? If the balloon's inside of the log, I swear to God. Oh, there it is. Inside of the log. Alright. That is Korok number 18 of 23. See you guys in the next one. Alright, our next Korok appears to be somewhere in the vicinity of this tree. Hopefully in the tree itself. Yep. Okay, the balloon pushed me out. The balloon is continuing to push me out, which means I have to shoot the balloon out instead. Alright, that's Korok number 19 of 23. See you guys in the next one. Our next Korok is right over here under this bridge. I think I see it right over there. Okay, gotta hit it a bit better. Come on. Okay, looks like I'm using the Master Sword instead. Or just doing this. There we go. That is Korok number 20 of 23. See you guys in the next one. Our next Korok is right over here. You can probably see it running around over there. So we head over here quickly and manage to catch it. If our stamina does not run out again. Come on. Grab it! There we are. That's Korok number 21 of 23. I'll see you guys in the next one. Our second to last Korok is right in here. Of course, with an ice wizard irritating us the whole way through. But it's fine. We'll just go ahead and dive in. And that was completely the wrong way to do it, of course. Yep, do that if you want. Just go ahead and jump in. And there we are. That is Korok number 22 of 23. I'll see you guys at the last one, completely ignoring this ice wizard still. Alright, our last Korok is right in this big tree, right here. Where on the tree, I'm not entirely sure. Oh, there it is. Boom. That's Korok number 23 of 23 for today. And before we go ahead and end things off, we are actually going to go ahead and teleport back to Korok Forest. Alright, here we are in Korok Forest. Let's go ahead and talk to Hestu. Shaka Kala, if you'll return my last Korok seeds to me, I'll expand the size of your inventory. Which stash do you want another slot in? Shokay, I'll just need 55 Korok seeds. Deal? Let the expansion begin. Expand-a-band-band, weapon stash, Shakala. Shakalo, you've enlarged all of your stashes. Nice. And with that, our inventory is completely upgraded. In the next episode, we're going to be continuing our hunt for Koroks because would I be genuine if I didn't still want to collect all of them despite having our inventory complete? We're also going to be doing another 3 shrines and another 2 side quests. It's going to be that way for another about 19 episodes or so. But we are essentially in the end hall anyway, so it's not a big deal. I will see you guys then. Bye-bye.